Anyway, this is our second show, and I'm not going to take a lot of time to tell you about what the critics said about our first show, although we did have some very nice comments in the Manchester Guardian. So there you are. And here I am, and here's the show.
The George Gobel Show. Starring George Gobel. With his guest, Hollywood's lovely Miss Angela Lansbury. Pretty Peggy King. John Scott Trotter and his orchestra.
Oh, he's so cute. He just kills you. Isn't he cute, Angela? What a boy.
Mm-hmm. I like his range.
Oh, gee, I'm crazy about his whole kitchen.
Peggy, have you seen my garter? Gee, I've got to have a garter. Look, could I borrow one of yours?
Oh, I don't wear garters.
Well, how do you keep your stockings from sagging?
Oh, I just pull them up all the way and tuck them under my shoulder strap.
Doesn't do for me at all. Yes?
Well, Angela, I was just wondering if we had...
Oh, gee, Georgie Goble.
Hi.
Gee, I just saw you on television and, oh, I think your voice is so...
See, that's what everybody says. My voice is just so.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I think that your voice is, well...
Alluring?
Oh, alluring.
And thrilling?
And thrilling.
And sexy?
Oh, sexy. Gee, Georgie, you just put the words right in my mouth.
Yeah. Well, see, a fellow like me just can't afford to take chances. Oh, Angela, there's nothing the matter, is there?
Oh, no, nothing, George.
Well, see, right after Peggy's song, we're going to have a commercial, and that's where you come on.
After the commercial, we do the scene where I play your wife?
That's right.
Uh-huh.
All right, I'll see you later.
Okay.
Peggy, it's time for your song now. Oh, excuse me. Angela, I won't be needing this. I'm not going to play my guitar after all.
For a minute there, I thought I was going to have to use thumbtacks.
Where are we going, Georgie?
Right over into this other set. I wanted you to see it because... see, this set was made just for you. This is where you're going to sing your song. You like it?
Well, yes, it's very pretty. What is it?
Oh, it's a mountain is what it is. I mean, anybody... Well, it's not really a mountain either. Now, what it is, see, it's a molehill left over from one of the NBC spectaculars. See what they did, Pig. I think this is important. They sent a large package to all the NBC executives, and what it was a molehill into a mountain do-it-yourself kit.
Gee, I'd like to get one of those.
A do-it-yourself kit?
No, an NBC executive.
Well, see, you just can't hardly get them no more. Sit down here. I want to tell you all about this mountain. This is called Lookout Mountain. And I know all about this mountain because, see, my brother used to work right here on Lookout Mountain. My brother. You know what my brother did? Well, right here he would stand on top of Lookout Mountain. And whenever he would see another mountain coming, he would yell, "Look out!"
Oh, look here. How did this music get here?
I guess the prop man put it here.
Is it my song that I'm going to sing tonight?
Well, now wait just a minute, sir. Are you going to sing a ballad entitled, "Let Me Call You Sweetheart, I Didn't Catch Your Name"? Well, now, don't get panicky, Peg. Are you going to sing a song called, "I Had a Feeling You're Fooling Till I Noticed You Drooling"?
Not tonight. Now, tonight I'm going to sing an old Rodgers and Hart tune called Mountain Greenery.
Well, I'll be a dirty bird. No wonder you've got a mountain set here, Peggy. That just goes to show you the shrewd operators we have working around here. You just mentioned to them that you're going to sing a song called Mountain Greenery, and just like that, 1 week later, they got a mountain built for you. And incidentally, they built this one the hard way by erosion. Sing, Peggy.
It is moving day. Spring is here, so blow your job, throw your job away. Now's the time to trust to your wanderlust in the city. Just you wait, just you wait. Where God paints the scenery, just two crazy people together. While you love your lover, let's take your cover, let's, when it rains, we'll laugh at the weather. And if I'm good, you'll look for wood so I can cook. While you stand looking, beans could get no keener reception in a beanery than our mountain greenery. Oh, mosquitoes won't bite you, dear. I'll let them sting me on the finger. We could find no cleaner from rice machinery than our mountain greenery.
Here to tell you that was real gone. Oh. But can I ask you something? When you hit that high note, did your shoulder strap break?
Well, how did you know?
Well, your stockings are wrinkled. Come on, you can fix them at the theater.
How many? Two?
I make it two. Are these in the balcony, or main floor, or loge?
What's the difference? We got seats everywhere.
Why is it that everybody I meet acts like they're a head waiter and I ain't got no reservation?